So by the year 2050, there are going to be more than 2 billion people who are older than 60 years old. And it has been estimated that around 80% of these 2 billion people will live in low and middle income countries, which is roughly the developing countries. It is currently a common belief globally that senior citizens should not work, do not need to work, and therefore there's no reason for companies to create jobs for them. I think this kind of thinking, the thinking that senior employment is inessential, is actually a seed of a major problem that could impact a lot of lives, especially lives of people in developing countries. To explain to you why, let me show you a diagram. And let me call this diagram a negative aging spiral. Imagine a 50 years old living in a developing country. The chance that this person will work later on will be slim. So this person is not going to invest in their skill, might not even invest in their health because there's no return from this investment. Then at the age of 60, this person is going to stop working because it's a common thing to do in these countries. And then after that, many bad things could happen. For example, this person might not have enough saving, or maybe no saving at all, and now there's no more employment opportunity. This person might feel lost, feel hopeless, feel lonely. This person might even feel like there's no purpose to continue living. So it seems like for many people in developing countries, there's going to be suffering through the process of population aging. Is there anything we can do differently? For me, as an economist who has been working on this topic of population aging, especially in the context of developing countries for many years, I have been puzzled by these questions. But I think I've got an answer. I think the best catalyst that we can use to break the negative aging spiral and unlock the power of population aging is to create something called senior employment technologies and use it to democratize senior employment. What is senior employment technologies? It is a technology that can be used to reduce or remove physical and cognitive barrier for work for senior citizens. Like people wearing glasses today, and we use it to, you know, erase or remove our vision problem, senior employment technologies is something that we can use to, you know, transform senior employment from scarcities to abundance. But unfortunately, this aspect of technologies has been overlooked by a lot of people. When we actually think about it, you know, senior living assisted technologies are quite common, but not so much in terms of senior employment technologies. And in the context of, for example, developed countries, these technologies do exist in some extent, but in the context of developing countries, these technologies is largely non-existent. So if we could create senior employment technologies and use our imagination to think about what it could be, what would it be look like? Let me give you guys a couple of examples. The first group of senior employment technologies is something that can be called physical augmentation technologies. There are two types of physical barrier to work. The first one is physical barrier at work. So as we age, we tend to lose some of our physical abilities. For example, we lose our muscle strength. We might lose our hand and finger dexterities. Now, let's imagine the possibility if we could create cheap and accessible exoskeleton technologies in which it is a suit that senior citizen could wear. And this suit can be used to augment, for example, trunk muscle. And senior citizen can actually use it to lift something heavy, but it doesn't feel that heavy. Now, if we actually think about it, this aspect of technologies could be pretty important in the context of developing countries, because a lot of people in developing countries actually using their body or their labor a lot for work. Next, let's imagine a possibility if we could create cheap and accessible collaborative robots, or cobots in short, which is often in the form of a robot arms. And these robot arms can be used as an extra steady hand that, you know, senior citizen can be used to recover their hand and finger dexterity, especially for work that require precision. One interesting use case for this could be for something like, think about senior surgeon in developing countries. in which we all can agree that, you know, we wouldn't want, you know, a surgeon with shaking hand, right, to doing anything near our body. But, you know, these technologies can help, you know, senior surgeon with amazing skill, amazing knowledge, to still, you know, make significant contributions. And we know, you know, in the period of population aging, surgeon, doctors, you know, will be in great shortage. The next physical barrier to work is the physical barrier in getting to work itself. So as we age, things like getting stuck in traffic or being in a, you know, a congested public transportation for so long or need to take long distance, long walking distance, you know, could be a major, you know, barrier to work for many people, for many senior citizens. Now, if a work does not require physical presence, let's imagine the possibility that a technology like remote working technology, such as, you know, Zoom or maybe in the future, Metaverse, can be used to completely remove the journey to work itself and allow senior citizens to work from anywhere, anytime, or maybe in any countries. If a work does really require physical presence, let's imagine the possibility that a technology like, you know, smart city technologies, that one aspect of smart city technologies focuses on, you know, optimizing city transportation resources by collecting data, information, and then, you know, from sensors or from cameras, and use it to improve the journey to work for senior citizens so that their journey to work can be better and safer. The second group of senior employment technologies is something that can be called a cognitive augmentation technologies. So as we age, we also tend to lose some of our cognitive abilities. For example, we tend to lose, you know, our ability to memorize things or our abilities to, you know, compare pictures, objects, which is called perceptual speech. Let's imagine the possibility that, you know, maybe our cell phone, our laptop, or maybe a virtual reality glasses can be equipped with cognitive augmentation software powered by artificial intelligence, which can be used as a companion brain. So in the future, this device can be used to help, you know, senior citizens, senior worker to, you know, show them information, work-related information as needed, so they don't need to memorize everything, which would be great for me right now too. And, you know, help enhance, for example, perceptual speeds when, you know, senior workers, senior citizens need to, you know, identify objects or finding defects, and they can actually make the final decision, you know, better and faster. Of course, beyond physical barrier and cognitive barrier that I have been mentioned, we still need to find a way to remove social barrier to work, which is called the ageism beliefs. It's the beliefs that senior citizens are always less productive than younger workers for any kind of occupation. I think senior employment technologies can take us one step closer to remove or maybe significantly reduce ageism beliefs. I think if we can do this thing, we can break the negative aging spiral and create something that can be called a positive aging spiral. Imagine a 50 years old living in a developing country, but in this case, this person actually invests in their skill, this person actually invests in their health because they know this investment will be valued. And not only that, this person actually looking forward to the next journey in their lives. Then at the age of 60, senior citizens who are qualified to work or could become qualified to work because of senior employment technologies, and this person need or want to work, should be able to work. If we can do this, I think we can achieve and become a wealthy and healthy aging society. So by using these technologies, senior employment technologies, in which when we think about technologies, what we have, you know, listen, some technologies might seem scary, some might seem concerning, but I think senior employment technologies is the right kind of technologies that our world, our society needs more right now. And we can use senior employment technologies to transform and democratize senior employment from scarcity to abundance. And I think we can use it to transform the lives of many people from suffering through the process of population aging to flourishing in the process of population aging. Thank you very much.